Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Frequent Flyers Bird Show. For your safety and the safety of our flying performers, please remain seated with your arms and hands down as our birds are trained to fly all over the theater. Thank you and enjoy the show.
Expecting to see a lot of birds, because that is exactly what we are going to share with you all. Birds from all over the world flying all over the theater. We are 100% birds 100% of the time. So hopefully none of you guys came here expecting to see any fuzzy mammals. I'm the only mammal you get to see today. You're welcome. Yes, glad you guys are very excited about that. Now, yeah, birds are going to be flying all over the theater. Now the birds are going to be coming from that side, and they're going to be coming from this side as well. So definitely keep those arms down, but we do want to get these birds as close to you all as possible, so get ready for it. Now let's see, I think we are just about ready to get started with one of our first birds out here. Now this first bird we want to share with you all is a newer addition to the show. He was actually hatched and raised right here at the Safari Park. Now when he was hatched, he was about yay tall. Now he is the tallest bird here at the Bird Show. His name is George, and he's going to be joining us from the opposite side of the theater. Yes! Now I love all of your reactions out here as George flies around here, because he is a very cool bird. Now George here is what's called a West African crown crane, and as he flies above your heads, see if you can spot that golden tuft of feathers right on top of that head. You guys right here can get a very close look at it, because that is exactly how they get that name, crown crane. Now George here, he was hatched and raised right here at the Safari Park, because unfortunately out in the wild, their numbers are not doing too well. Now there are 15 different crane species, and 11 of those crane species are actually considered vulnerable or endangered. Now here at the Safari Park, we actually have 6 different species of cranes set up for breeding, including George. So we're very happy to have those birds. And it's not only because of those birds that we have here that their numbers are getting a little bit higher, but just by you guys visiting us here in the park, you're all helping us out as well. So we appreciate each and every one of you. Now, seeing George flying around here is a pretty cool sight. Another cool sight to see is this bird in a large flock with his family members out there, just like you would out on the savannas of Africa. Now, if you have not yet ridden the Africa Tram today, you will actually get that chance today. Out on the Africa Tram, you can spot a whole flock of East African crown cranes at some point today if you check it out. But it looks like George is making his way on out of here. He did a great job. That was George, our West African crown crane. Now, if you just can't get enough of him, you can actually spot his parents out there as well today. If you guys have walked around the Mombasa Lagoon out there, right across the lagoon, his parents are hanging out there. So maybe you guys can go say hi to his parents for us. But for now, we do want to share with you guys another bird. It's a little bit different, but it is also another pretty big bird. Do you guys want to meet another big bird out here? Yeah, it's good. We figured you would say that. So we have another one. Now this bird is a nocturnal bird of prey. Now when you guys hear those words, nocturnal, bird of prey, what bird typically comes to mind? The owl. Oh yes, everybody knows. Good job. You guys know your bird species. Now, we do like to go big here. So we want to share with you guys not just any owl, but we want to share with you the largest owl found out in Africa. Now I see some of you guys kind of looking around trying to figure out where he is coming from. I will help you out. Focus your attention toward the top of our NeoVision screen as we meet our Pharaoh's Eagle Owl.
Whoa! Wow!
Wow is right! This is Thatcher!
Yeah.
Woo! Now Thatcher here is a Pharaoh's Eagle Owl, like the largest owl found out in Africa. Now this guy is nocturnal, meaning he is going to be doing most of his hunting during the nighttime hours. So as he's flying around here, he has quite a few adaptations to help him with that. This bird is what we like to call a sit and wait predator. Just exactly how he was sitting there, he's gonna wait out prey, he's gonna sit atop the trees in Africa. He's gonna use his camouflage to blend in with his surroundings to help hide from that prey. Then using his eyesight and his hearing, he's gonna hone in on that prey that could be anything from a small rodent, a small reptile running around on the ground. Then he's gonna swoop down using his silent flight to his advantage to sneak up on that prey and then enjoy it for dinner. So very, very great adaptations, but it looks like he made his way on out of here, doing some great flights out with Thatcher, our Pharaoh's Eagle Owl. Now, Thatcher there was a pretty big bird of prey. Do you guys out here wanna try and guess how much he might weigh? I hear like 5 pounds, 10 pounds. Those are all 30 pounds. He only weighs about 4 pounds. Yes, wow is right. Now that bird there is gonna be living out in Africa, so that size will help him out. And typically birds of prey are solitary animals, so looking a lot larger might help survive as well. Now, this next bird we wanna introduce you guys to is a little bit different. They are a lot smaller, and typically birds of prey are solitary, meaning they live and hunt by themselves. But this next bird is a bird of prey, yet they will hunt with family members. Now ours is called a Harris Hawk, and he's gonna be joining us from the top of the hillside, right over here. His name is Spike. Now Spike, you'll notice just how much smaller he is. There he is. Whee! Now Spike is a Harris Hawk, and these guys are found right here in the United States. They're found in areas like Texas, Arizona, and New Mexico. Now he is found in those desert areas. So you'll notice his colors aren't very bright. He doesn't need to have those bright colors. But this bird, again, is gonna be using numbers to their advantage rather than size. He's gonna come together in groups of maybe 3 to 5 individuals to bring down prey. Woo! Good ducking down there. But he is doing some great flights out here and maybe making his way back home with a little tail wag goodbye. He's really thinking about it. There he goes. He's out of here. That was Spike. our hair is on. Yeah, very, very cool bird of prey there. Now, let's see. We have been bringing the birds a little bit closer to you guys, but for this next one, we'd like to have some of you guys come closer to us. So, if we have some adult volunteers out here that are feeling brave today, raise your hands nice and high. We're gonna pick a couple of you. Everybody, you in the blue shirt up there? Yeah? Everybody, right here? Come on up. Oh, you guys are very excited. I love it. Okay, Autumn's getting some people up there. How about you up there in the tank top? Come on down. All right, you guys are gonna join Autumn right there. She's gonna take you up on stage. Now, for the rest of you guys out here, how many of you out here have seen the movie The Lion King? Woo! Woo! Yeah, it is a good one. Now, in that movie, do you guys remember Zazu? Yeah. So Zazu is Simba's little bird friend, and he is a type of hornbill. Now, hornbill is the bird that we wanna introduce you guys all to next. And there are actually 54 different species of hornbill found throughout Africa and Asia. Now, we want to introduce these guys to one of Zazu's cousins found out in Africa, one of the smaller hornbills found out there. Hello. Now, this bird is very good about flying around her forest, even better at hopping around that forest. Now, as you guys can see, we do not have a forest out here. Instead, you guys are going to become our forest for us. So, if you guys want to straighten up this line just a little bit, you're going to put your arms out nice and straight. There we go. All right. Put them up a little bit higher. There we go. All right. So, you guys are going to try to make it a little bit even here because you are our branches. And this little bird is going to hop across there. You guys ready for it? All right. Everyone else, focus your attention toward Autumn because here comes trouble. Don't worry, it's just her name. Don't be scared. She is a yellow-billed hornbill. She's quite adorable, and she's very good at hopping. Woo! Yeah! Now, you guys did a great job, so she's going to do it again. So you guys put those arms up nice and straight. Yep, there you go. Because once she is done with her very delicious treats, she's going again. Oh, boing, 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 boing. Yay, she did it! That was trouble! Yeah! Now you guys did a great job as well being that forest. So one more thing. Put your right arm out, bend it across your stomach, and take a bow. Yay! Good job, everybody. You guys can come on back. Yeah! We can train the birds, but we can also train the people. All right, let's see. Okay, so you guys have met quite a few different species of bird. We want to introduce you to a whole other species, a type of parrot. Now, some of you all out here might know somebody that has one as a pet in the household, or you have seen one of many YouTube videos of these birds learning how to talk. Now, what they're actually doing is they're imitating different sounds in their environment. This little African gray parrot here has been hanging out with us at the bird show for quite some time, picked up all kinds of things. So he's brought Alyssa out here, and they're going to show that off for you guys.
Yar. Thanks, Karina. Good afternoon, everybody. How are you guys all doing today? Woo! Good, good. Glad to hear it. I know, Saturday, we got some nice weather today, right? Hope you guys are enjoying your day. My name is Alyssa, this little guy here. His name is Congo. He's an African gray parrot. And like Karina was saying, these little guys, they are very well known for imitating sounds that they hear in their environment. And Congo, of course, he's no different. The sounds that he hears, though, well, they are a little bit strange and unusual because Congo here, he lives next door to the office backstage. Yeah, so as you can imagine, he's picked up lots of office sounds over the years, right? Things like our telephone. Yeah, the sound of the landline backstage. There are trainers running to answer the phone. That never rang. Yeah, all day long. Yes, and Congo here, he often thinks it's funny. Yep. He laughs at us every time. But our phone, that landline phone, it's really old. It's like 20 years old. It's modern times now, right? And he is just like all of us. He carries around his very own cell. Yeah, here's your ringtone, my friend. That one's a bit outdated. He also lives next door to our water cooler back there, and it makes the sound of bubbles. Yeah, they're just little bubbles, though, right? He's a little guy. Oh, Congo Buddy, if you hear that, they think you're cute.
Okay, we're having a good time out here, but we do actually need to take a moment and get serious for a minute. Is that okay?
Okay.
All right. I always have to double check. I have to make sure that he is ready to move on too. I don't know. He didn't sound like he was very serious about that one. I think we should check again. Congo, really?
Okay.
There we go. That's much better. Much more serious sounding right now. I know he's actually ready and we can keep on going. Because we do have a serious topic that I do want to make sure we touch on. Conservation, because it's such a huge part of what we do here at the park. And Congo here, he knows good all you guys when it comes to conservation. You've all really taken charge. It's true. You're not just helping us out, of course, here at the park, but every time you guys come and visit us, you're actually helping us support our conservation programs all over the world. That makes Congo here really excited. Yeah, he is excited about those things. He knows, you know, just help us with those big, well-known, popular animals like elephants or rhinos or tigers. Even duckies. Yeah. We can't forget about them. They're important too. All those little animals as well though. Something most people probably don't really think about. Could actually be something that is critical to our environment though. Something like a teeny tiny frog. I don't really know what that one is. Apparently it's a squished frog today. That's okay, we're gonna keep on going anyway. Because I do want to make sure we touch on something that does actually hit much closer to home for Congo here. You see, there are bad guys out there, right? They're called smugglers. What do? They take his wild counterparts out of their natural habitat and they illegally sell them into the black market country. It's not a good thing, right, that happens with these birds. And not just these little guys here, this does actually happen with parrots all over the world. Now, Congo here. He is familiar with this problem, and I know he has a very strong opinion on the matter that he wants to share with you today. So, but everybody out there is looking at you, and they all want to know, what are your feelings on poachers? Yep, I thought so. Nobody likes poachers, right? All right, he does have his very own special way, though, to say thank you for coming out and seeing us today. Ready? Why don't you give them all a great big kiss? Yeah, he's a pretty nice little guy. That was a juicy kiss, Congo. But Karina is back, and I know she has some more really fun birds that she is going to share with you. But that means Congo and I, we got to leave. So, buddy, before we go, why don't we very politely tell all of these very nice people, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, everybody. Have a great day. Very impressive, all the things that little bird there has learned. But we do have a few more birds to share with you all. And now this next bird is quite unique. You guys may have actually seen some as you've been walking around the park today. But they are very special to us here. We have a lot of conservation efforts going on with them because they are very beneficial to our environment. Now this bird we want to introduce you guys to is a type of vulture. Now vultures, maybe some of us out here have been called a vulture at some point in our lives, and maybe not in the best way possible. Well, by introducing you guys to this next bird, we're hoping to change your minds because, again, vultures are very beneficial to being out in the environment. We like to call them our cleanup crew. Now we're gonna introduce you guys to a little black vulture named Daisy. She's gonna be joining us from the top of the hillside, and there she is. Now, Daisy here, these black vultures are found over on the East Coast, but these birds are very beneficial. They're gonna be going on eating what's called carrion. Now, carrion are the dead carcasses of animals that are often rotting along the side of the road. Now, although that might sound very gross, it is very beneficial because as those carcasses are sitting and rotting in the sun, they're often spreading disease. Now, these birds are able to resist that disease that come off of those carcasses, so they're helping clean up environment, so we love having them around. Lucci is out of here. That was Daisy with that cute little vulture walk. Daisy, our black vulture. Now I mentioned you guys might have seen some around the park. Here in San Diego, you can see, the turkey vultures look very similar, just their head color is a little bit different there. Now, you can see some of these vultures' cousins today. If you guys have yet to visit Condor Ridge, definitely recommend it because they are one of our biggest conservation efforts going on right now, the California condor. Now here at the park, we're actually helping to breed them. Back in the 80s, there were only about 22 individuals of those birds left. By us being able to breed and research those birds, their numbers have gone up to over 450 individuals. So yeah, very impressive. Yeah, give yourselves a round of applause because it's all because of you guys joining us here now. So yeah, definitely check out Condor Ridge at some point today. Now, we do want to share with you guys another very unique bird. This one you guys may have met if you've been walking around the park today, but I want you guys to use your imagination out here and picture the height of George, that crane we met at the beginning of the show, but this bird having the attitude of an eagle. Now, if you've walked around the heart of Africa Loop today, you've met what's called the secretary bird. If not, you're about to meet one. Now, I see this little bird flying around here. That is not the bird. That is a native crow that likes to hang around here. But this bird we're talking about is a lot larger and a lot different looking. Now, they're unique for a few different reasons. The main reason, this bird is the tallest raptor found anywhere in the world. Now, the word raptor, we typically think of hawks, eagles, owls. The word raptor literally means to grasp with their talons, which is the way most of those birds hunt. Now, this bird is considered a raptor, but they have a very different way of hunting their prey. Now, joining us on the hillside, this is RN, our male secretary bird. Now, this bird is found throughout the tall grasses of Africa. He can fly if he wanted to, but why would you fly when you can stand taller than the grasses and you can run up to your prey and stomp it to death? Kind of looks like a bad kung fu movie, doesn't it? Now, those powerful kicks are in hopes of stomping on that prey, immobilizing it, and then swallowing it whole. These birds are going to hunt prey such as small mammals, reptiles, and even venomous snakes. Those midair kicks you're seeing, he's also been seen to kick locusts straight out of the air. Yes, very impressive stuff. Now, as he's been kicking around, you'll notice his wings going out just like that. That is how these birds are going to distract their prey so that if the snake were to strike at the bird, it will strike at the feathers rather than the body. But it looks like he's taken his final bow back there. He's out of here. That was RN, our male secretary bird. Now, the name secretary bird, kind of a funky name for a bird. He's definitely not a secretary and he is not taking notes out there. But we think maybe this modern day and age, those birds might be preferred to be called the administrative assistant bird. Yeah. But in all seriousness, we do want to tell you guys how much we appreciate all of you joining us here today. We've mentioned it a few times, but we are only going to keep saying it because without you guys, we wouldn't be able to do anything you see here at the show or out in the park. Each and every one of you guys are our heroes for wildlife. So we appreciate all of you for joining us, and all we can say for that on behalf of myself, Rudy, and everyone here at the show is thank you. Thank you guys for joining us.